In this video, I'll be assembling the frame. And as always, I welcome your subscription. Now that I've glued all the M5 nuts into the tool mount and both nut traps, here I am assembling the tool mount to the 1-inch pipe with the nut trap installed inside the pipe. Off camera, I've also drilled the holes out in the pipe out to 7mm, as I find this gives me a little bit more play and makes it easier to adjust the assembly. With the tool mount installed to the pipe, I'm now installing the Z lower plate onto the assembly. I'll just lightly tap this down with the handle side of a hammer. After installing the Z lower plate, I then went and installed the Z motor plate above. I just brought this plate down so that the spring coupler just lightly touches the bearing on the Z lower plate. After which, I then went and placed the whole assembly on a flat table so that I could check everything was flat. It took a fair bit of just tweaking it back and forth to get it to sit flat. I find that twisting it in both hands until you can get it sitting flat was the easiest way for me to do it. It's also a worthwhile note that the M5 socket cup bolts that I've chosen to use sit slightly proud of the tool mount. I might have to grind these down later. With both the Z plates installed and the tool mount fastened and the whole assembly sitting flat with no play or wobble against a flat surface, I then went and checked the measurement spacing all around the tool mount, all around the Z motor plate and Z lower plate with a tape measure. After getting the heights all matched all around, I then went and installed the M3.5 bolts with a bit of Loctite and the nuts. After assembling the Z axis assembly, here I am assembling the XYZ T8 piece for the center assembly. Once again, I've chosen to install the nylocks on back to front with washers. I find that if I use the nuts the other way around, as the same with the rollers, there isn't enough length to engage the nylock properly. Some areas of this assembly where I did want to use a washer, there wasn't enough room for the washer to fit on the part, so I tin snipped the side of the washer off for the areas that needed it. After assembling both the XYZ T8 pieces, I am now assembling both the X and Y pieces. Once again, I've found that certain areas I've had to tin snip down washers to be able to get them to fit, and I've also installed the nylocks on back to front here as well. After assembling both the X and Y pieces, I'm now assembling the entire center assembly. I've taken a washer and put it on the 130mm M8 bolt. I put the M8 bolt through the XYZ T8 piece from the top down. I then went and put it through a nut lock, then through an XY piece with a bearing on the inside. I then went through the next X and Y piece with a bearing on the inside of that one as well. It's worthwhile to note that we've chosen to use Allen key socket cup M8 bolts. There are a lot of areas on the center assembly where the heads of the bolts foul on other bearings or on the XYZT8 piece. So I've had to take the assembly apart several times to grind the top of the heads off just so the assembly will fit together. After grinding down the bolts on the X and Y pieces on both sides, I've also noticed that the top bolts on the top and bottom side of the X and Y piece also need grinding down as well. With the top side bolt and the bottom side bolt on the two XY pieces ground down, I'm now reassembling the center assembly with the same steps as before. After reassembling the center assembly with the XYZ nut lock, XY, XY nut lock, XYZ T8 pieces, I'm now installing the last four bolts in the assembly, which go through both the XY pieces into the side of the XYZ T8 piece with a bearing in the center. I've also used washers and I've put the Nylox on back to front. These four bolts were the M8 65mm bolts. With the center assembly completed and all finalized and put together, as per V1's instructions, I've slid in two lengths of the 1-inch pipe and I'm now checking the assembly for squareness. However, I've found that straight away it's actually pretty good. With all of the rolling assemblies completed, as well as the feet, about the only notes I can leave is just to order slightly longer bolts than what you need. Next, I'll be starting the assembly of the frame. Here I'm assembling the roller carriages onto the outer frame of the X and Y rails. I found that by rotating the carriages around each pipe, some roll better on some lengths of pipe than others. So it's worthwhile just testing each carriage out on each length of pipe and seeing how it rolls. Off camera, I've also given the pipes a sand down with some P240 grit sandpaper and just wiped the rails down with some WD-40 on a rag. This has really helped to free things up. Here I am assembling the frame. It's important to take note that when installing the feet, the belt staunchion needs to have the angle side facing inwards towards each other of both feet, as shown here. The way I've configured this rail, this side will be the side closest to me. And this is how the rest of the sides should be configured, facing outwards. After assembling both sides of the X-axis outer frame, as shown, I'm now installing the upper Y rails onto the frame. It's important to install these with the roller plate facing outwards, and then when installing the top corner bracket to ensure that, as before, both of the belt staunchions have the angles facing inwards towards each other. After installing all four of the top corner brackets, I'm going to pin the frame down with two bolts in each side. That way I can make some jigs to square the frame. To make a jig, I've gang cut four pieces of timber to my width and length inner dimensions. Here I am tie strapping in the pieces of timber. I'm going around the frame with a tie strap and then inserting the cut pieces of timber in between the tie straps. I've done this on both sides of the frame, and I'll do this for both the X and Y directions. After strapping the frame square, I then went around with the end of a hammer and tapped the corner assemblies to relax them onto the frame. Next, as per V1's instructions, I'm taking a corner to corner measurement to check the frame for square. However, I find it's spot on, so I'm going to start tightening down all four corners. With all four corners now tightened down, I'm removing the jigs and tie straps from the frame assembly. After removing all four pieces of timber, I am now working on installing the center assembly. Decided to check it for squareness again. However, it's still pretty much spot on. After checking the center assembly for squareness, I'm now installing the motor mounts above the roller carriages. Off camera, I've drilled these out to 5mm holes also. And I'll just lightly snug these down. With all four of the motor mounts installed, I'm now installing the NEMA 17 stepper motor at both ends of each axis. Here I am installing these with the 4 M3 10mm socket cup bolts. And I'm just lightly snugging these down as well. Here's the complete assembly, all finalized and put together. One thing I kind of wish I did differently was to keep the waste board separate to the machine and leave the spoil board as a separate island. To do this, I would have had to have included the waste board thickness in the cut calculator at the beginning. However, at this stage, everything seems to move freely and nicely. Not too easy and not too much effort. I don't have my lead screw yet, so next I'll be starting the belts and then I'll be doing a bit of wiring as well. I also didn't realize when using the cut calculator that it calculates the cut area and not the external dimensions of the machine. I did actually intend to do a smaller build to start off with. I was planning on doing a 2-foot by 3-foot build, but I'll run with this and see how it goes. I think I've just accepted that I'm going to have to build it several times to get the machine the way I want it. Here I am installing the belts on the y-axis side. I managed to find some GT2 steel belted belts relatively cheap on eBay. I'm just looping off one side with the teeth engaged against each other with two zip ties, and then I will zip tie this to the staunchion on the other side. After zip tying one end of the belt to the staunchion, I'm now feeding the tail end of the belt underneath the first roller bearing over the motor shaft with the pulley installed underneath. I've made sure to orientate the flat side of the motor shaft towards the first grub screw on the pulley. I'm also just going to lightly nip this up now so I don't lose the orientation. After which I then went and threaded the tail end of the belt back down and through and around the pulley, and then looped the belt back around again, and then used two zip ties to tie the belt back off again. With the belt tied off and under tension, I'm now cutting the belt to length that I need it. I decided to use some of these spring dampeners as I use them on my 3D printer, and they work quite well, and they're relatively cheap also. To install them, you just hook one side in and then stretch the other side over and around the belt. Thanks for watching. In the next video, I'll be starting on the wiring. And don't forget to subscribe.